We just saw the three billboards outside of
Ebbing,
Missouri.
Hey, fuckhead!
What?
Don't say what, Dixon, when she comes in calling you a fuckhead.
The more you keep a case in the public eye, the better your chances are getting it solved. And when I
see the sun. You know, if you hadn't stopped coming to church, you'd have a little bit more understanding of people's feelings.
All this anger, man. It just begets greater anger.
Strong characters, strong writing, beautiful movie, the setting. I thought it was North Carolina, you said, right?
Yeah, but it was supposed to be in Missouri, right?
Yeah, they filmed in North Carolina. Beautiful. Beautiful setting, amazing script, amazing acting, violent when it needed to be, funny when it didn't need to be, which is perfect. Hit you in the heart. Hit you where it counts. Sam Rockwell killed it. Woody Harrelson killed it. The main actress, don't know her name. Do you know it?
Frances McDormand
killed it. Great.
And what if he was just passing through town?
Pull blood from every man in the country then.
And what if he was just passing through the country?
If it was me, I'd start up a database. Every male baby was born, stick him on it. And as soon as he'd done something wrong, cross-reference it. Make 100% certain it was a correct match, then kill him.
Yeah, well, there's definitely civil rights laws prevents that. I'm doing everything I can to track him down. I don't think those billboards is very fair.
The time it took you to get out here whining like a bitch, Willoughby, some other poor girl's probably out there being butchered right now, but I'm glad you got your priorities straight. I'll say that for you.
I give it like an 80, 80, 85, 85 out of 100. Really enjoyed it. Good time.
Dope. What up, man?
I would say that it was satisfying, yet not overindulgent. It got its point across, but it didn't really like linger on anything for longer than it had to. And there was a surprising amount of character development and growth.
Yeah. What would you give it out of 100?
8.5 out of 10.
8.5 out of 10?
Yeah.
All right, so I loved it. I thought it was great. I mean, mostly the story, the characters, they were, you know, they had depth. They were well designed. You know, you weren't really sure how to feel about all of them. You know, you're mostly rooting for Frances McDormand's character. You know, her daughter died, and she's trying to get like justice. And she will have her revenge. And so you're like on her side. By the way, she's the best superhero I've seen all year long. And I've seen all of them. To me, this is a superhero. She was like, I will have my vengeance. And nothing will stop me.
We've had 2 official complaints about those billboards.
From who?
There's a lady with a funny eye.
A lady with a funny fucking eye?
And a fat dentist.
There's a lot of good friends of Willoughby in this town, Miss Hayes. Ow! You didn't happen to drill a little hole in the dentist today, did you?
Of course not.
Huh?
I said, of course not.
I'm sorry about Angela, but the town is dead set against these billboards.
You know who threw that can?
What can?
How about you, sweetheart?
No, I didn't really...
Go, girl.
I will say I had some issue with Abby Cornish plays Woody Harrelson's wife in it. And she looked young. She was young. And it took me out of it. And she had an Australian accent, which Abby Cornish is Australian. And, you know, I'm just like, in Ebbing, Missouri, are there a lot of Australians? Maybe there are. Maybe have nothing to do with it. But are there a lot of Australians that are young and marry old sheriffs? Because that's a thing. I don't know if that's a thing. So it kind of took me out of it. That was like my biggest complaint. And they had a couple like, you know, coincidences that were like, non-believable for me. So each of those little things drew away from it a little bit. But overall, I loved this. I laughed more in this than most comedies. I mean, I was just totally enthralled. And it made me think about how great movies are. You know, it was a movie that made me love movies. So I really loved it. Let's see, anything else I want to say about it? Well written. There's stuff in this that I will remember. This is a memorable movie. So, all that being said, I'm going to give it a 92 out of 100. It's like one of my favorite movies of the year. So, I just loved it. All right, that's it. Peace and
in
love.
In 3, 2, 1. And as sad as the spectacle of these billboards might be, this reporter, for one, hopes this finally puts an end to the strange saga of the three billboards outside.
This doesn't put an end to shit, you fucking retard. This is just a fucking start. Why don't you put that on your Good Morning Missouri fucking wake-up broadcast, bitch?
The more you keep a case in the public eye, the better your chances are getting it solved. And when I see